If you read the title, you might be a little confused. When will the internet be faster than FedEx? If you want to mail something to your friend across the country, the best FedEx can do is overnight delivery. But you can send them an email and they'll get it in seconds, and it won't cost you $70. But we're not just talking about a little bit of data like an email, we're talking hundreds of gigabytes. Now that might sound like a lot of data, but companies like Google ship internal data like this all the time. And you remember that image of a black hole from 2019? That photo was taken by 8 radio telescopes on 4 continents, 2 in Hawaii and Chile, and 1 in Arizona, Mexico, Spain, and Antarctica, all synced together to scan the skies for several days in a row. But all that data had to come together in one place to be analyzed. Well, actually 2. MIT's Haystack Observatory in the US and the Max Planck Institute for Radio Astronomy in Germany. An email attachment just wasn't going to work. The observatories had to collect 5 petabytes of data. If you don't know what a petabyte is, that's the thing 2 spots above a gigabyte. So 1 petabyte is 1 million gigabytes. A normal photo on an iPhone 12 is about 2 megabytes. So that black hole picture was the equivalent of about 2.5 billion pictures, or about 1 teenage girl's Instagram story. Over typical US internet speeds, that data would have taken 30 years to send, even longer uploading from Antarctica. So instead, just like Google, they used FedEx. But will FedEx always be faster? Well, this comes down to bandwidth. If you added up all the internet traffic today, it would come out to 167 terabytes per second. FedEx has a fleet of 669 aircraft, mostly made up of Cessna 208Bs and Airbus A300s and A310s. Altogether, their fleet has a combined lift capacity of 26.5 million pounds daily. Since a typical 1 terabyte computer hard drive weighs about 150 grams, this all means that FedEx is capable of transferring 75 exabytes of data per day, or 7 petabytes per second, almost 50 times the current output of the internet. But we can definitely improve our efficiency. Top-of-the-line SSDs have a storage density of up to 160 terabytes per kilogram, which means that a FedEx fleet loaded with SSD cards could transfer about 177 petabytes per second, 1,000 times the internet's current traffic level. Cisco, one of the few companies hated even more than Dish Network, estimates that internet traffic is growing by about 29% annually. At that rate, the internet would overtake FedEx around the year 2040. Of course, by then the amount of data we can fit on a hard drive will have only gone up. The only way the internet could catch up to FedEx is if transfer rates grow much faster than storage rates, but this will probably never happen. All the data on the internet needs to be stored somewhere, so as the internet becomes faster, so will storage systems. But while FedEx is big enough to keep up with the internet for at least the next few decades, there's no technological reason we couldn't build a connection that beats them on bandwidth. There are experimental fiber clusters that can handle a petabyte per second. A cluster of 200 of these would beat FedEx, but running a line like that all the way to Antarctica would cost more than the GDP of some countries. So the bottom line is that for raw bandwidth, the internet will probably never beat FedEx, and it looks like we'll be shipping data for a long time to come. This video was based in part on the book What If? By the creators of the xkcd comics. It's a pretty interesting book, filled with answers to these sort of short hypothetical questions. If you're interested in checking it out, there's a link to the book in the description below. Be sure to let us know what you think of the video down in the comment section. And remember, there is always more to learn.